Dr. Graham Hill is a criminologist and former senior investigating officer with the Surrey Police. During his career, Graham worked to solve some of the UK's most high-profile and infamous crimes, including the murder of Millie Dowler and the London night stalker Delroy Grant.
Someone has to be in charge. Someone has to bring the investigation towards its ultimate conclusion.
Graham, who specialises in child abduction and murder, assisted the Portuguese police in the investigation into the disappearance of Madeleine McCann. In this series, he's using his own insider knowledge and expertise to unpack the investigation from the inside out.
The public only ever sees the tip of the iceberg. I want to tell the full story and reveal how detectives brought a series of elusive killers to justice.
This is Murder Detective. East Ham, London is a vibrant multicultural community where different ethnic groups, by and large, live in harmony together.
East Ham, it had been a very working class area up to about that time. You then get waves of immigrant communities coming in from Eastern Europe, from Asia. But these communities were very much isolated. They kept themselves to themselves, very often not even speaking English. So whatever was going on, whatever crime may have been going on within those communities, it usually didn't spill out onto the native community, as it were, of East London.
East End of London had always been a working class area, and in parts you could even describe it as a deprived area. It was, it had its problems. Every area, all over this lovely country of ours, you'll have that, where the vast majority of people are wonderful and deserve to be looked after, and there'll be a group of people who are preying on them. East End was no different.
In early 2004, tensions in the area exploded into terrifying violence. Graham Hill is in East Ham to revisit the circumstances surrounding a seemingly random and vicious attack. On the night of the 12th of January that year, police received a call about a young man being viciously attacked on Higham Road.
Police sped to the scene, as you would expect, and they found a man lying in the road. He'd clearly been beaten savagely. From the beginning, they could see that there was multiple wounds and multiple series of different types of weapons. Very quickly, they found out that cricket bats had been involved, and sticks, and bars, and even reports of a hammer and a sword. This was a savage attack by any standards.
He wasn't dead, so it's being investigated as a grievous bodily harm, as an attempted murder. So the preservation of his life, the preservation of his health, has to take precedence over evidence, and that has to be managed very carefully.
The medical team has to do a number of medical procedures to try and save that person's life. And sometimes that can influence and complicate the forensic examination, because you've got clothing on the victim that might give information and clues, and also you've got injuries on the body that you would want to try and see at the earliest opportunity. But clearly the medical treatment the person is getting takes priority.
The very first port of call would have been the uniform officers that are working in the area. And their immediate task would be to seal the scene, to preserve witnesses, to see if the cordons were in the right place, to start the initial inquiries, is to make sure that at the very initial investigation that is being dealt with in a professional way.
There were people taking other people aside, quiet words here and there. There was intimidation going on, which is the hallmark of a gang involvement in this shocking attack.
The situation was quite difficult at the beginning because there was lots of bystanders, and what became very clear is that there was a bit of a whispering campaign going on in the crowd.
While the investigation team started to gather evidence, the victim, Maheshwaran Kanishan, or Mahesh, was fighting for his life.
Because of the severe injury, his head was broken in six places, and there's a brain swell, and the doctors in the hospital tried to do whatever they can to keep him alive.
While his heart was beating, and while his lungs were providing his body with oxygen, the damage to his brain meant that he was essentially brain dead.
3 days after the vicious attack, Maheshwaran Kanishan was pronounced dead. The case for grievous bodily harm became one of murder.
The minute that Mahesh dies, the Metropolitan Police deem the incident a Category A murder. A Category A murder is where the offender is unknown and there is a considerable community impact as a result of the murder.
I'm on my way to see former Detective Chief Inspector Clive Driscoll. As an SIO, Clive has been involved in some of Britain's most high-profile murder investigations. Clive, how did you first learn about the murder?
I learned about the murder when I got a phone call. I was at home from Mr. Briggs, who was my chief superintendent. My team actually only did historical murders, that's what we were doing. And he suddenly announced that because of the high level of murders they'd had in this area, that we were going to help out the murder team.
First, the investigation team needed to learn more about Maheshwaran Kanishan, a Sri Lankan immigrant who was living in the UK.
He was a poor fisherman with a poor family, a very basic standard of living. But his village was within an area that was controlled by the Tamil Tigers, which was a separatist Tamil organisation which was fighting a 20 or 30 year civil war with the Sri Lankan authorities. This was a dangerous situation for him and his family. And he was offered the opportunity to come to this country illegally, start a new life, when he could send money back to his impoverished family. This seemed, on the face of it, a good idea.
He paid money to an organised gang who brought him to the UK, promised him a better life, promised him that he'd get work, when in fact what he found himself was in